Guess spring is almost here, so it's time to do some spring cleaning. But moms, you don't have to do all the work. Let's get the kids involved as well. Deborah Stumm from Supermoms 360 is here today to tell us what kids can do around the house really all year long, and especially
all year
right
round
now.
Exactly. And the first thing I say is get them started young. If we instill this early, they will be better helpers all throughout their lives, which is really good. Another thing with kids, you definitely want to be patient. Mm-hmm. They're not little adults, they're kids, so we need to help them along the way. And then also make sure things are age appropriate. And the things we're going to talk about today are just guidelines. So of course everyone knows their own child the best. So pick what's appropriate for your own child, and then you can keep adding on as they get older.
Okay, so how young should we start? Like age 3? Is that an appropriate
time? Yeah, so exactly. So the first age group that we have is 3 to 5, and it seems pretty young, right? But they can start to do things very young. So things like putting away their toys, just tidying up after themselves. They can also put their shoes away, put their clothes into the laundry basket, and they can even start to put the placemats out. I even had mine start actually clearing their plate, if you've got plastic, of course. If you've got glass, that might not be
China.
Exactly. Don't use the fine china with kids ever, is my advice. But they can get them started really young. And then moving on to 6 to 8-year-olds, they can do a little bit more. They can start tidying up their own room. They can put away the clean laundry. They can actually set the table. And then they can also help you with the dishwasher with supervision, of course.
Okay, and then the 9 to 10-year-olds, we can give them a little bit more responsibility. They're
yes.
starting to, you know, they're almost teenagers now.
They're getting there. They think they're teenagers
right,
at 9
exactly.
to 10, right? But I definitely, for 9 to 10, you can even get them started cleaning up their own bathroom a little bit more, wiping down the sinks, the mirrors, things like that. You can also have them help you with some dusting and definitely cleaning up those rooms much better than they did at the earlier stages.
Okay, and then the tweens and teens, they think that they're so independent.
Oh, yes.
You know, they can do it all. So we really want to make sure that they have responsibility and they learn how to do chores.
Exactly.
As well.
And this is the time when you can really get them helping you with your weekly cleaning activities. So a much more thorough cleaning. They can do dusting. They can do mopping. You can get them started on the vacuuming. I think this is a really important time because you're teaching them now things that they're going to need to know as adults.
Okay, perfect. So moms, dads, you definitely don't have to do all the cleaning. Get your kids involved. And I think a great way to motivate them is do like a point system and do rewards. So tell me about that.
Yeah, well, I think number one, you want to outline what the expectations are.
Mm-hmm.
So here we have a little chart. This one, of course, is more appropriate for the younger kids, but so they have it right in front of them. What is it that I am expected to do?
Mm-hmm.
My personal belief is there are certain things that are just part of being a member of the family. So there are certain items that are part of your normal day-to-day responsibilities. However, as far as rewards, like you were saying, maybe you have optional items, and if you do a certain number of those every single week, then you get your allowance, or you get a special treat of sorts. Another thing, this cute little pom-pom container here, this is good for little ones as well. So maybe it's kind of a gotcha being good type of a situation. So you're helpful with your brother or your sister, you do some little extra things around the house, you get a pom-pom put in your container, and then maybe you get to do a special outing with the family, things like that. So I do think rewards are good. Of course, kids love the rewards, but I think it's also important to let them know that there are certain things that are important just being part of our family. It's responsibilities that we all need to share. So mom doesn't have to do it all.
Exactly. I know some people say that it's kind of like bribing the kids and that can't be good, but there is a positive way to do it.
Yes.
And it teaches them good work ethic. You
exactly.
know, you get paid for working.
Exactly.
So it's nice to reward them with maybe a new toy or something after a couple weeks of doing good chores. You know, not every time, but
exactly. Exactly. So if they're keeping up that good behavior, it's certainly nice to have something positive. And for your child, it can be something, it can even be stickers, it can be smiley faces, whatever helps motivate them and keeps them moving in the right direction. Definitely.
Okay. Perfect. So supermoms360.com. We can find more information about what we just saw here today and then a lot of other helpful mom tips.
A lot of great things. With Easter coming up, we got some good tips on Easter too, and we'll be back next week to talk about those.
Deborah, thanks so much for coming.
Thanks, Kristen.
See you next week.
Yep.
Thanks so much.